and what? As a travail upon a human child, and we shall not escape. They shall not escape in the end. It should not be strange to us, because they have neglected the salvation Jesus has, and I don't have a
we worship you, we give you honor, we give you glory, we give adoration to you. For you are the God that answers prayer. And the Bible says, for this reason shall all flesh be gathered unto you. Father, we are gathered before you once again, whether I pray, to speak to our hearts in Jesus' name. Lord, you sent your word and you heal that disease. Father, your word today shall heal us in the name of Jesus. Father, you shall establish our faith once again in you in the name of Jesus. Thank you for what you have done. And the saints shall say,
Amen.
We don't take much of our time. We're discussing something very vital today, titled Faith and Faithfulness for Our Eternal Salvation. Amen. How many of you know what salvation means? Salvation. Before I go deeply into the message proper, like I always like to do, I would like to explain to you what the topic of the message is, what it really means, so that from there we can get an understanding of what we are talking about. Faith and faithfulness. Faith is a kind of belief. It's a kind of explained in Hebrews chapter 11. Verse 1. Believing in what you have not seen. Believing by the virtue of no substance. That is what faith means. Now, none of us have seen God, yet we have faith in Him. Am I right? That's why you are here. None of us have seen God, yet we believe in Him, and we believe He exists. That is why we are here. So faith is like believing for no reason. Believing without a substance. Are you with me? Not saying, okay, I believe I will eat this morning because my mother is already cooking. That is not faith. Are you with me? You won't say, because my mom is cooking, say, I have faith that I'm going to eat this morning. No, that is not faith, because you already see you've seen the food on the stove or on the cooker. That is not faith. But faith is believing without a reason. Believing for no substance. Now, faithfulness is not here, it's not regarded as the act of having faith. It is regarded as what? An act of being trustworthy. An act of standing solely by what you have believed. So that I know whom I believe. Amen. Amen. And I am persuaded that He is able. Are you with me? That is a kind of faithfulness. That I have believed and I know whom I believe and I know what I believe in. And I am persuaded. That means nothing is going to change my belief in it. The Bible says, this quotation, I've been quoting it over the time of recent, Revelation chapter 12. It said, and they overcame the dragon by the words of their testimonies and the blood. It said they love not their whole soul, even unto what? That means they are persuaded that they know whom they have believed, and they are convinced that what they believe is true, and they remain faithful even unto death. Are you with me? So faithfulness is a sign of trustworthiness. It's a sign of complete obedience. It's a sign of believing without wavering. It's a sign of standing and walking worthy of what you have believed. It's a sign of standing and walking worthy of the call that God has called you. Are you with me? Then the next word here is what? Eternal. Let me break eternal salvation into two words. Eternal. Eternal here is like something that lasts forever. Are you with me? Okay, forever might look a bit big again for some people to understand. Eternal or forever means something without an end. I believe everything, every one of us understand what it means by the word, what you mean by the word end. End in Russian is called konet or konser. Amen. You understand? Something without an end. Amen. So, eternal is something that is endless. Then, that's what the Lord Jesus told us that, I mean, the Bible told, tells us in the book of Psalm, when he said, why do you seek after listening of vain things? Things that are physical, things that we can see, they are temporal. You can see me, tomorrow you might not see me again. I can see you, tomorrow I might not see you again. That means the body we are carrying, they are temporal. The body we are carrying are not eternal. Then the soul, your soul I cannot see. But by the virtue of your soul, your body is moving and your body is acting. Then your soul is eternal. Then when we talk about eternal salvation, let me go to salvation. Then before I talk about eternal salvation together. When we talk of salvation, salvation was gotten from the root word called to save. Save. I don't know that in Russian. It means to save. Then before salvation can come in, there would have been incarceration. Amen. Incarceration might be a little bit big word again. I will explain. Incarceration is like imprisonment. Imprisonment can also be another big word. I will explain further. Imprisonment can be like being encaged. I think every one of us know what is called cage. Then I think I've brought it to a simpler form. Okay, it can be like being locked up. You know the meaning of locked up, to be locked up? To put someone into a place and lock it up. Now, I said without that, there is no need for salvation, or there is no need for anyone to be saved. Then when salvation comes in, it's an act of coming to set free. We all know freedom. Freedom means svobody, am I right? Amen. Freedom, it means to be released from a kind of incarceration, like I said, or from a kind of imprisonment, or from a kind of enslavement, or from a kind of encagement, being encaged, setting you free completely from everything that holds you bound. Am I right? Then, this is when salvation comes in. Salvation is the act of doing that. Amen. Then I'm going to explain the words eternal and salvation as one meaning. Eternal salvation here means the salvation that is endless. The salvation that is forever. The salvation that you will not go back to be entangled. Are you with me? It is not a temporal salvation. Listen to me. I was explaining to you earlier that you can see me today and tomorrow you don't see me anymore. That means my body you are seeing is temporal. I can see you today and tomorrow I don't see you anymore. That means the body you are carrying is what? Also temporal. So also, I'm going to explain this. If anyone is imprisoned, this body is imprisoned. And maybe I happen to be a lawyer. And I go there that you must grant this person a bail. You have imprisoned him for no just cause. He must be tried, first of all, in the court of law. Before you have the right to imprison him. I have been able to set him free from the imprisonment. Am I right?
Yeah.
I've been able to save him from the imprisonment. But because the body I have saved from imprisonment is a temporal body, I am unable to grant that body an eternal salvation.